كن فريدا عش بفخر في الحياة لا تبالي فالمعالي بالتحدي لا سواه كن سعيدا كن فريدا عش بفخر في الحياة لا تبالي فالمعالي بالتحدي لا سواه بالتحدي لا سواه.
First, I would like to remind you of something that you already know. That you are obviously a chosen few. With your numbers so low in this university, Muslim students, it means that you have been chosen out of the many Muslims that do exist in the country to be here in this university. So you shouldn't look at your presence here mainly from the perspective of what you seek from this university. Of course, you're here to gain a degree which would be used to further your life as a citizen of the country, to give yourself a means of looking after a family. However, that is the same intention of all of the students that are here. They're here for the same purpose. As Muslims, we have to have a higher purpose. This is what distinguishes us from non-Muslims, that we have a unique goal which should distinguish us from all of the other students. That requires us to be conscious of two types of students that are here in this university. Two types of Muslim students. One, who is a student who happens to be a Muslim. And the other one is a Muslim who happens to be a student. I repeat that. Muslim students are of two types. A student who happens to be a Muslim, and a Muslim who happens to be a student. The student who happens to be a Muslim is like any other student. He or she will do what all students do. And one of the things which students are well noted for is cheating. Students who seek to gain high marks so that they can get into other areas of study, to be successful when they graduate, they take the shortcut, which is cheating. Students all over the world are known for cheating. So, that student who happens to be a Muslim. He could have been a Buddhist or an atheist or a Christian or any other religious persuasion. He is no different from the other two. So he will cheat as they cheat. Whereas a Muslim student, a Muslim who happens to be a student, he or she is Muslim first. Their being Muslim is priority in their lives. They look at everything from a Muslim perspective, not merely from that of a general student. And this is what each and every one of you, as Muslim students, have to come to grips with. You have to decide whether you are Muslims who happen to be students or students who happen to be Muslims. I hope this point is clear. Is this point clear? Just to bring this point across more, I would like to ask Muslim students here, how many of you can raise your hand and swear by Allah that you have never cheated in any examination? Okay, or test. You have never cheated in any examination or test. Swearing by Allah. Allah is your witness. I can see two hands. Okay? Three hands. Alright? Some people say at least they're honest. But it is saying something. It is addressing the reality which I spoke about. Were you Muslims who happened to be students, then all your hands would have risen. Because you all know Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us very clearly, man rashana falaysa minna. Whoever cheats us is not of us. So cheating is not in the vocabulary of the Muslim who happens to be a student. But for the student who happens to be a Muslim, that's normal. So, at this point, it is necessary for you to decide, to make a decision. Where do you go from here? If your intention, if your goal, ultimate goal as a Muslim is paradise, then you need to make the commitment. You need to decide this evening, this afternoon, to be from here on forward Muslims who happen to be students. Meaning you could have been anything else. You could have been doctors, teachers, taxi drivers, whatever. You are Muslims first. First and foremost. The future of Muslims in this country depends on students who are Muslims first. They are the ones who ultimately will be able to change what we are presently living in. Students who happen to be Muslims, they will be a part of the problem. We have problems here. Problems currently in the Muslim community. Students who happen to be Muslims will be a part of that problem. They will continue to perpetuate that problem. Whereas the Muslim who happens to be a student is the one that truly will be able to make a difference in the future. And on a personal note, you might not think that there is very much that you can do. Things are the way they are. And you just need to be a part of what everybody else is doing. However, I was born in Jamaica. You all know about Jamaica, right? What is Jamaica known for? Bob Marley. Recently, Usain Bolt is Jamaica. I was born in a Christian family. Both my parents were Christians. They migrated to Canada, so I grew up in Canada. I went to university in Canada, majoring in biochemistry. And while I was in university, I converted to Christianity, to communism, from Christianity to communism. I became a communist. You know what a communist is? A Marxist-Leninist. A person who believes that there is no God. That this world is governed by economic principles. The full stomachs and the empty stomachs. However, they claim that with the principles of communism, they would make people equal, make society just. Everybody would have an opportunity to work. The state would take care of everybody. However, after some years as a communist, I came to realize that it was a dream. In fact, communism was unable to even compete with capitalism. And communism was very vicious. In Russia, Stalin killed millions of Russians in the name of communism. In China, Mao Zedong killed millions of Chinese in the name of communism. And there were no moral principles. Whatever benefited the communist movement is good. Whatever did it was bad. So it could change anytime. And after I understood where communism was headed, I decided to look elsewhere. And at that point, at the age of 25, Allah opened the door for me to see Islam. I studied it. And I accepted it.
Masha'Allah. Takbir.
So from there, I tried to learn as much as I could about Islam, which wasn't very much in Canada at that time. So I went to Saudi Arabia. I studied in Medina University, studied Arabic, and studied Islam from its sources. Then I went to Riyadh, became a teacher in high school, junior high school of Islamic studies in Arabic. Did a master's in Islamic theology, Aqidah. Following that, I began a PhD from University of Wales in the UK in Islamic theology and graduated and became a professor in university, the American University in Dubai, for 10 years teaching Arabic and Islamic studies. Then I set up departments of Islamic studies in universities. I went to India, set up a university in Chennai, southern India, Tamil Nadu. And in 2007, I launched a university online, the Islamic Online University. Since 2007, 8 years later, 7 years, 7.5 years later, we now have over 200,000 students. 200,000 students studying in this university, Islamic Online University. We offer degrees in Sharia, in English, with Arabic, in psychology, in education, Islamic banking and finance, business administration, information technology. And this university is among the biggest universities in the Muslim world, with the most diverse student population of any university in the world. 225 students, countries are represented. Virtually every country on the face of the earth are studying in this university. Over 20,000 of the students studying here are from the US. 18,000 from the UK. 15,000 from Canada. And the rest from all over the world. 14,000 from India. Now, if somebody had said to my parents, when I was born there in Kingston, Jamaica, that your son is going to become a Muslim scholar, who would do this, do that, do the other. I've also written more than 50 books, published books on Islam, different topics. If that had been told to my parents in Jamaica, they would have said, impossible. Impossible. However, Allahu Akbar. Allah could make that happen in spite of my beginnings, where I began from. You all are beginning from a far better position than I do. As students here, you are probably in your 20s, early 20s. You are already Muslim. You already have an idea of Islam. And you can make a difference. You can do far more than I have done. So, do not not look at yourself as being unable to affect any change in this country, in the situation of Muslims. Allah can facilitate, can make you be the one who can make a difference. So, I'm only bringing this message to you to remind you of your role as Muslims, first and foremost. Meaning that everything that you do here at this university, every course that you take, every activity you're involved in, you should always keep in mind that you are Muslims first. Meaning that you have to look at everything from an Islamic perspective. And for sure, there's an Islamic perspective for everything that you do. If you don't know what it is, then, as Allah told us in the Quran, فَاسْأَلُوا أَهْلَ الذِّكْرِ إِن كُنْتُمْ لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. Ask those who know. If you don't know, find out. Go and find out what does Islam say regarding this or regarding that, etc. You have a duty not to just sit in your classes and absorb anything that is given to you, anything and everything. No, you have to look at it critically from a Muslim perspective. But that, of course, as I said, requires that you know what it means to be a Muslim. You know not just the five pillars of Islam and the six pillars of Iman. You understand Islam. You are living Islam. And I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us all true Muslims, Muslims first in all the various areas of our lives, Muslims first and Muslims last. Barakallahu fikum. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.